So we're going to use with statements in this particular example. So I'm going to go into my developer tab, Visual Studio. I'm going to create a module, and within the module I'm going to create my sub any name I want. So I'm going to call it sub my Africa, any name you want. Then press enter after the quotation marks. Now you're in my Africa. What I want to do in this example is cell B2. This cell B2. I want to do multiple things to B2. I want to change the word in B2, so I'm going to use try as my default word. So I want to create multiple actions. So I'm going to enter a comment here to remind myself of what I'm doing. So change cell B4, B2 properties. So I'm changing multiple properties here in cell B2. So the first property I want to change will be the text. So object.property, so the object we are talking about now is cell B2. And I want to change the value to happy. That's the first task I'm going to perform. After this code runs, the second task I might want to perform is changing this same B2, changing the font color to red. So that will be font.colorindex equals to red is number 3. Let me drag this a bit here. After changing the font to 3, I want to change the back color. So range B2 again, dot interior, dot color index. And let's change the back color to blue. So I have the back color or the interior as blue. I have the font color, the text color to be red. And then I have the value change to happy. All this is taking place and affecting cell B2, which is range B2. Let's run the macro, my Africa, run it. You see all three things has happened to cell B2 at once. So we could have written 100 lines of code to affect its width, its height, anything we want. But at times, having so many lines of code for one item can be tricky because you're typing and copying and pasting. So there's a more efficient way to do this. So what I would like to do first is to comment out this code. So I can either put single quotes on each line and comment it out. There's a faster way to do it. You can select all the lines you want. Then you see a toolbar here, which is the edit toolbar. If it's not there on yours, just right click on the bar and click edit. And there you have your edit toolbar. There's a tool here that comments, creates a block comment. So here I am, just commented out this code. I can uncomment it when I want. I can comment a singular item, like standing behind it. I can uncomment it. So I'm commenting these three lines of code, and I'm writing with a with statement. So my comment will be using the with statement. So the with statement starts by using the word with, and then the object name. So with range B2. Then after the with statement, you end it with an end with statement. And when you click out, you see the end with has been capitalized in proper case, first alphabet proper. So I normally write the block of code first, and then I write what I want. So with range B2, all I need to do is press the full stop, and it behaves as if it's at the end of this statement. So range 2 dot what? So dot value equals to happy. Next line dot font dot color index equals to 3, and then dot interior dot color index equals to 5. So that's the short form or a very neat way to have all the code affecting one item in a with statement. So with property, then it ends with an end with statement. So let's rub out what is here. let's go back to the default background color type, and let's just type something random here, like Ivory Coast. Ivory Coast, then let's change the font color, the base font color to black. So here we have our default. So we're going to perform this with on this cell and see it change. So developer, macros, my Africa, and there we have it. The with statement is a cleaner form of code, is a more mature type of code. If you want to indent, you could have actually used the indent tool here to indent back or forth. So this is how maybe yours will look like. I always want to indent my code so I can read my code more clearly. So that's how to use the with.